Discrimination against white people has become as big of a problem as discrimination against black people and other racial and ethnic minorities. The percentage of white people who agree with this, 52% of all whites. 76% of Tea Party supporters, which, you know, says something about the kind of thinking that draws you to maybe the Tea Party, which is not good or bad. I mean, it just is. 61% of Republicans, 58% of working class, 38% of Democrats, and 39% of all people with a college degree. So you do understand that the more educated you become, the more liberal and to the left people tend to become, okay? The less religious, the less likely to believe in creationism, the left, like, there are all sorts of things that go along with an education, which is why it's very dangerous to a lot of people. But look, what I want to do is, after today's class, I want to come back to this question and see what we think about this. The 52% of white people in the United States think that discrimination against white people has become as big of a problem as discrimination against people of color. And mind you, I haven't really talked about this issue today. So this is really the first day that we're going to go into some things. I did it. Okay, go to the next slide. So we're going to watch this video and I'm not going to do any commentary on it. Let's just watch it, and we'll go from there. And as you're watching the video, keep in mind it was 9 police officers involved.
Resisting! Get out!
That's a kid!
Resisting.
It's a fucking kid!
Stop!
Get off of him! That's a kid!
Stop resisting! Get off! Stop resisting! Get out!
Boy Dig was jaywalk. He stepped off the bus and he jaywalked. And the question that I have for everybody is, okay, I know a lot of you are saying, when the police come at you, you just obey them. Really? You're a 15-year-old kid and the police come at you and with a baton and they're like, hey, come over here, kid. Do you just obey them? How many of you obeyed? How many of you have ever had that happen to you? How many people who live in all-white communities at your bus stop, have you ever seen somebody being taken down by the police? Maybe one of you have. How often have you seen it? How often do we see that? Middle-class communities, upper-middle-class communities. What would happen in an upper-middle-class community if some upper-middle-class white kid, first off, but then white kid, got harassed by the police and beaten up by the police for jaywalking, and then beaten up because he walked away from the police, who said, hey, come over here, and he just kept walking because he was trying to get to school. And it's just a question. And so you can watch one example of this, but we're not going to talk about one example today. We're going to talk about a pattern that we see over and over and over again. And I want to start this because when we see one example, it's really easy to disentangle anything and say, well, the kid should have been listening. Have you ever had somebody coming after you with a baton, even a police officer? And like, what are you going to do? You're going to grab the baton. You're not going to just let the dude swing it. I don't care who it is. You're going to grab the baton. You're going to try, and they're going to say, let go, let go. Like, if I let go, you're going to beat me with it. So I'm not letting go. And you're 15 years old, and you're hanging on. And so all the people who want to make, if you're sitting there saying, but he should have done this, he should have done that. It's like, well, there are so many things maybe that should happen, but maybe we should live in a society where police don't beat the shit out of a 15-year-old kid for jaywalking. What kind of a world do we want to live in? Then we got to ask the question, are young boys and young girls with dark skin most likely to experience this, more likely to experience this than light-skinned kids? The answer, I'm sure we can all say, is yes. And then the question is, how much more likely? That's the next question. Okay, so that's what we're going to talk about today. How much more likely? Okay, so I'm not saying the kid, this young boy, didn't do anything wrong. What I am saying is there is a pattern of violence that we see that is against people of color, and where does this come from? There's a pattern of violence by the police toward everybody. Toward everybody. We live in a world where we've built up police forces that are paramilitary policing. Paramilitary. They're like militaries. So it's a pattern of violence against everybody. So this is what we're going to talk about. So let's see where it starts. Go to the first one. So here.